Good morning, everyone. Welcome to today's market commentary. So today we'll be looking at 4-hour time frame chart of Nifty. So it's clearly visible to us that there's a trend line resistance over here, and today's candle, it seems to be settling above the trend line resistance. Along with that, if you closely observe, this is a downtrend in Nifty, a small bounce back, again a downtrend, and again a bounce back. So this whole pattern, if you look at it carefully, is a double bottom chart pattern. And for this double bottom chart pattern, you have a neckline at 11,850. Now this 11,850, on one hand, it is acting as a neckline for this double bottom chart pattern. On the other hand, earlier it acted as a very strong support. So from that line itself, every time we had a bounce back. This was the first time, and these three times there was a bounce back. So this support, it got converted into resistance here, and now it is acting as a neckline for this double bottom chart pattern. So overall, if a 4-hour candle can settle above 11,850, a bullish journey can be seen until 12,000 easily. So that's around a 150 point on the upside. And if it can sustain this 12,000 level also, 12,100 can be easily seen. So all we need on Nifty now is a close above this 11,850, that too on a 4-hour time frame. So currently the value of RSI is somewhere around 53. So we can expect that by the time it crosses this resistance level here above 11,850, if we have a close above 60, as far as this RSI is concerned, that's going to be a double confirmation for us for a bullishness. So on Nifty, the final conclusion is that it has already crossed this trend line resistance. Now if it can close above 11,850, on the upside, around 150 point target zone is there, and there's no strong resistance in between that. And coming to Bank Nifty, even Bank Nifty also, this is a double bottom chart pattern. So the neckline is already crossed, and this is the trend line resistance. So the trend line resistance and neckline both have already crossed in Bank Nifty, and it is also trading above R1. So in Bank Nifty, only bullish signals are visible. So when Bank Nifty goes up, we know it drags Nifty also on the upside, because Bank Nifty's weightage is around 1/3 in Nifty. So the next target for Bank Nifty we can fix as 31,400. So that's around a 500 point from now. So we'll take the stocks from participant side now, and I request everyone to put their stocks in the chat box. Only the stocks which are present in FNO. RBL Bank, a clear bullish divergence here. RSI going up and up. And price, we can clearly see that this low is lower than the prior low. Of course, there is not much difference, but at least when price has come to the same zone, here RSI is shifting upwards. So that's definitely a bullish signal for RBL Bank. And if we consider this as a double bottom chart pattern, this price level becomes the neckline around 640. So above 640 in RBL Bank, good bullishness can be seen. Next is Auro Pharma. Aurobindo Pharma, day by day, we could see a very big fall. So this is the support zone for Aurobindo Pharma. Here you can see for many days, price has halted. So we have made that as a support zone right now. And yesterday also it was a piercing pattern. We can even take the help of trend line resistance here. No proper trend line resistance. So we'll see 20 SMA as well. Yeah, so this is the decision making level for Aurobindo Pharma around 628. So around 628, there's a continuous resistance starting from 14th June. And today it is 26th June. So 12 days have passed by. And still 628 is not crossed on the upside because there is a distribution zone and the 20 SMA also acted as a resistance there. So 628 is the decision level for us. If price can settle above that, we'll keep shorter targets on the upside. So first 656, so around 28 rupees on the upside, and there is a gap here, and if the stock can cross the gap again, we'll be keeping the prior high. So this is the level, this is the target zone, and if price settles above this again, you will be putting 703 as your target, like that. So our entry level would be above 628. I'm not aware of this stock actually, so I cannot give a review. So Pidilite mostly is in bearish zone below the central pivot point and 20 SMA, and both of them are acting as resistance here. See this, today's high, it got rejected from 20 SMA, and since 24th June, there's no candle which got settled above this central pivot point. So mostly Pidilite is on the bearish side. So we can expect a support for Pidilite at this support S1 of this month, of this week, around 1209. So McDowell's is approaching its strongest resistance right now. First is RSI is not above 60, so we cannot be sure that it is going to surpass this resistance level. Second, this is this trend line resistance, and third, monthly R1. So it should definitely face a resistance near this trend line resistance. It's Apollo Tires or Apollo Hospitals. Please put the complete name. And Hexaware, a huge volatility here. Not good to take a position right now. There's no pattern at all. See, Hindalco, we have seen earlier as well. One thing which is acting as a strong resistance here is the gap. So this gap zone is acting as a resistance. If it settles only below this gap level, it's not going to be bullish. Only above this gap level, Hindalco can be bullish. And even if above this gap level, you still have 206 as a resistance, and again R1 of this month as a resistance. So I don't recommend trading in this stock right now. When Axis Bank also, there is no proper pattern here. Or the earlier trend line support, how is it acting? So that is acting as a support. That's all we can conclude from this pattern. So here, although it closed below, it got bounced back. Again here, although it closed below, it again got bounced back. So pattern getting repeated. That's all visible here, and it's already in bullish zone. And the last stock for the day, Apollo Hospitals. So Apollo Hospitals, this is the strong support, 1282, because that was a resistance earlier and that got converted into support right now. Okay, it's Apollo Tires. See, again, Apollo Tires, it did not give a proper close above this level. So until we have a good close above this 201.25, we cannot be on bull side. So wait for a close there, or if it becomes a bearish candlestick pattern again, that will be a chance to be on bearish side. So these are the stocks and indices for today. Thank you all for joining.